Welcome to another session of electrochemical corrosion, that is pitting corrosion or localized corrosion. Before that, subscribe the channel. At the end of the session, you'll be able to define what is pitting corrosion. You'll be able to enumerate the reasons for pitting corrosion. You'll be able to explain the mechanism of pitting corrosion, and you'll be able to suggest the preventive measures of pitting corrosion. At this point, I would like to tell you something, that is, at the end of the session, we'll compare galvanic corrosion, differential aeration corrosion, and pitting corrosion. That is because all the three has a relationship, and if a situation is given, you need to identify what type of corrosion it is, when a galvanic corrosion becomes a pitting corrosion, and when differential aeration corrosion becomes a pitting corrosion. Let us understand what is pitting corrosion. It is a localized attack in the metal resulting in the formation of a pit, hole, or a cavity. This type of corrosion is confined to a small point or a very small area. Let us look into the detailed reason for pitting corrosion. When the anodic area is small and cathodic area is large, it leads to drastic corrosion at the anode to form a pit or a hole. We'll see why this happens. We all know that at cathode, reduction occurs by taking up the electrons. When the cathodic area is very large, the demand for the electrons is also too high. This cannot be satisfied by the small anodic area. So, the anode undergoes drastic corrosion in order to satisfy the large demand of the large cathodic area. This is why when the anodic area is very small, drastic corrosion occurs and it forms a pit to undergo pitting corrosion. Let us see in detail all the causes of pitting corrosion. As we have already said, when the anodic area is small and cathodic area is large, pitting corrosion occurs. Why this anodic area becomes small? That is, when there is a damage or a crack over the protective film, or there is a scratch or a cut edge, if there is a local strain on the metal, if there is ununiform stress over the metal, if there are any defects on the metal, that defective area becomes the anode. If the metal is slided under load, there can be a scratch or a damage to the protective film on the metal. There can also be chemical attack, that is, in the environment, if chloride or some corrosive environment is present, it can damage the protective oxide layer. This also can become the reason for pitting corrosion. The surface roughness or non-uniform finish on the surface can also lead to pitting corrosion. Turbulent flow of fluid over the metal is also another reason for pitting corrosion. This we have already discussed this example in galvanic corrosion. Anyway, we'll just look into it again. That is, when a damaged tin-coated mild steel container is left out and drained, the damaged portion acts as the anode because the fresh mild steel is exposed at that point and all throughout the container the tin is coated. So, the damage is very small and the anodic area is very small and the cathodic area is very large. So, we have the situation of pitting corrosion. At the anode, corrosion occurs in order to satisfy the high demand of electrons by the large cathodic area, and a pit is formed at the anode. The same effect is going to happen if there is a damage in the protective metal oxide layer. We all know that all the metals form a metal oxide layer over it. Even if the layer is protective in nature, although the corrosion does not occur in such protective metal oxide layer, if there is a damage, the damaged portion acts as an anode, and if the damage is very small, the anodic area is small and the cathodic area is large, and it leads to pitting corrosion. This is another example of pitting corrosion which we have already discussed in our previous session of differential aeration corrosion. That is, this occurs due to the poor maintenance. That is, if the vehicle or the component or the machines are not maintained well, there can be dust accumulation or water droplets over the metal area. So, beneath the water droplet, the aeration condition is very poor. That is, it's poorly oxygenated and all the other area is well oxygenated. So, it leads to differential aeration corrosion. But in this case, since the anodic area is very small, because beneath the dust particle or a water droplet, it's going to act as the anode. The anodic area is small and the cathodic area is too large, it leads to also pitting corrosion. That is, at the anode, in case the metal is iron, iron gets oxidized to liberate electrons, and as the metal is a good conductor of electrons, these electrons flow through the metal, and when it meets the water droplet, the oxygen and water takes up the electrons to form hydroxide ion. And these hydroxide ions and Fe2 plus ions diffuse towards each other to form the corrosive product, that is rust, in between the anodic area and the cathodic area. And the anode undergoes drastic corrosion because the anodic area is small and the cathodic area is large. And it leads to the formation of pit. So this case becomes a pitting corrosion. Let us look into the mechanism which we have already discussed in the previous example. At anode, iron gets oxidized to liberate electrons. And at cathode, it depends on the medium. If it is acidic medium, that is hydrogen evolution type, the electrons released at anode are taken up by the H plus ions present in the acid to form hydrogen. And if it is alkaline or neutral medium, which is oxygen absorption type, the oxygen and water takes up the electrons to form hydroxide ion, which combines with the Fe2 plus ions present at the anode to form ferrous hydroxide. In the presence of excess air, this ferric hydroxide gets further oxidized to form ferric hydroxide. In case there is no air at that environment, it forms a black rust or anhydrous magnetite. This ferric hydroxide is nothing but yellow rust, which is very common. Let us see how to prevent this type of corrosion. We said that anodic area is small and if cathodic area is large, it leads to pitting corrosion. So in our design, we should see that the anodic area is larger than the cathodic area. And if possible, we all know the cathodic protection is a very good method of protecting the metals, but it's better to avoid, because in case there's a damage in the cathodic film, that is, as we have seen, the damage of tin coated mild steel container, that damaged portion acts as a small anodic area and leads to pitting corrosion, which is very dangerous because it forms a hole and it totally spoils the metal. And regular maintenance of the components or machine or vehicles so that dust accumulation or moisture is minimized. And uniform and sufficient aeration should be present so that in case there is any damage in the oxide layer, there should be a possibility for the oxide layer to be regenerated. This is possible when there is good aeration around the component or the vehicle or whatever is the situation. And we should also control the environment. We should see that in our surrounding area, the temperature is normal and the pH is also normal. It's not acidic or alkaline in nature. And there is no chloride concentration or corrosive medium concentration in the environment. Now, as I've said in the beginning of the session, that we'll discuss the differential aeration corrosion, galvanic corrosion and pitting corrosion. We should understand that all the types of galvanic corrosion does not lead to formation of pit. Similarly, all the differential aeration corrosion will also not lead to formation of a pit. A typical case, whenever a situation is given to us, we should see where is the anode, that we have discussed in many sessions of electrochemical corrosion, that is, only anode undergoes corrosion. The first point is to identify the anode and then identify the cathodic area. If the anodic area is small and the cathodic area is large, only then it will lead to pitting corrosion. Otherwise, a galvanic corrosion will be present only if two dissimilar metals are in contact in the presence of the corrosive medium, which we have detailedly seen in our previous session of galvanic corrosion. Similarly, differential aeration corrosion occurs only if there is difference in the environment, aeration condition, that is when a part of a metal is exposed to a different aeration condition compared to the other part of the same metal, that is the poorly oxygenated area acts as the anode and undergoes corrosion. But in any case, if the anodic area is small and cathodic area is large, it leads to pitting corrosion. I think you are very clear with pitting corrosion, galvanic corrosion and differential aeration corrosion. To see in detail, watch the video on differential aeration corrosion and also galvanic corrosion. Let us meet again with another session of electrochemical corrosion. Thank you. Until then, bye-bye. Don't forget to subscribe the channel. Bye.